Carmelo is definitely about, you know, taking the initiative to really, really look into things and be passionate about what you're learning about and apply that knowledge to whatever field that you go into.
The Afro-Puerto Rican community has always been relegated to the bottom. And that's one of these songs it's about. We're in 2002. Okay. This is definitely post civil rights movement in the 1960s and a whole bunch of other things that happened in Latin America, post-revolution, post all sorts of things. And we still have the Afro-Puerto Rican community completely ostracized. Yes, Jennifer?
And also I think part of his anger in the song is with like the people of Puerto Rico of all races that are kind of reminiscing about the good days of like Spain or their mother. Like it says, a good mother doesn't spoil her children, assholes, brown nosers, fuck Spain. Because it's like they didn't benefit with Spain in any capacity.
It was really interesting that one day that you came when we were listening to the rap song, and it was fascinating that we covered material that I was planning to cover 3 weeks later, but they kept pushing me to talk about these other issues that I wasn't planning to discuss at all. And so I just took the opportunity. It's like, this is the most natural way of introducing this material, so let's just do it. Yes?
Well, I like how he says, fuck Spain, because he doesn't say, fuck the USA. He's keeping it in context, like saying, never heard Ruben Berrios advocating for my people. Mm-hmm. Like, it's one thing if he's saying we should be Puerto Rico, but, you know, Puerto Rico is a white Puerto Rican, blah, 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 what have you.
That's where the beginning of it came to be, recognizing.
That's correct.
Where it all
And that's why at the beginning he talks about that racial trilogy. Mm-hmm. That's what we talked about of the Institute of Puerto Rican Culture, the African, Taino, and Spaniard. Once again, it has been Puerto Ricans have been educated into this trilogy to the point that it shows again in popular songs.
It's great that you said education, because what does he say right here with your I wanted to
I was on the second page.
Yeah,
it's on the second is right there.
For who else would think of filling an innocent children's mind with inconsistent education. Do you remember the Jamaica Kincaid quote here about how libraries and schools, the point is to devalidate the history of the colonized?
This is one of the reasons why we're doing Tego, and then we're doing Jamaica Kincaid.
It's good. We should do Tego before everything we do. <That's good.
laughs> Carmel's sort of famous for getting out the map, and so you can really understand the geography of the place that you're studying. And that's very important to understand first, and then you can understand the history of the place that you're studying. And then from there, you can look at the different cultural aspects of the country, like the literature and song and dance and paintings and graphic work.
Because see, I mean, I am just so intrigued by, you know, the United States going over and, you know, colonizing Puerto Rico and taking away the land. And every time I read poetry, I just take it like, you know, they talk about America taking their land from us. So that's what I read into it.
It's not everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It is in many places, but it is not everywhere. And this is one of the places where it is not.
I challenge them. And I sort of question many of the things they say at many points, because it is not about feeling good about yourself every day. This is not therapy. This is not about, oh, poor guy, you know, you had a rough life, so I'm going to give you an A in this class. I refuse to do that. That's counterproductive.
I want to change my topic.
So what?
I want to change it to the land.
Change it.
Yeah.
You have till midnight.
All right. I was gonna do.
No, but do you want to do?
I'm sick of talking about women. I don't want to. Do
you want to do? Do you want to do New Yorican poetry, or do you want to do the land in something else? Do you want to do painting?
I kind of wanted to compare and contrast the land in writers, poets, every kind of writer. From the island and then in the mainland, and what implication that has and why that is. And
he'll say things like, for when you write your book, you know, this will be really good for when you write your book. And it's just in this encouraging way that makes you feel like, yeah, you are at an academic level when you're with Carmelo and when you're in a class with him, that he really raises the bar and expects the students to work at this very high academic level.
I gotten pickier. Just so you know, okay? All the papers I liked, but what I have done now is that I'm sort of starting to problematize the way you argue things.
He's not an easy teacher at all. It's funny to like a teacher that, I mean, usually you look forward to going to a class because it's, you know, it's not tough to do. But this, it's like, it's 3 hours of hard work, I think. You know, like when I have my cigarette break halfway through, I need it. But you walk away feeling enriched and like you just did 3 hours of work that amounted to something rather than sitting in a class for 3 hours that just took up, you know, an eighth of your day.
Can you tell me what this means? $5 for members of the Jewish and Puerto Rican communities? What the hell is that?
Yeah.
I live in Humboldt Park, man. Do I get $5 for that? I'm a member of the community.
Well, don't complicate their lives. I would say make it
Could
a project
I say
for
like
this class.
My great-great-great-grandfather was Jewish, and so I'm a member of the Jewish community?
Oh, isn't that fascinating?
So
isn't that
like
fascinating? For members of the Jewish and Puerto Rican communities.
So
how the fuck
members,
do you define that?
Do you have to be members of both? Or
Puerto Rican card, or what do you do?
Well, guys,
yeah,
sure. here's proof of how important this course is.
Yeah.
Because the Field Museum of Natural History in the city of Chicago is putting sentences like this.
Yeah,
I'm assuming that everybody will understand.
Yeah.
This is fascinating. Thank you, Ren.
My fear is that they're going to sort of, Carmelo said, this is it. This is the way it is. And I hope in all my classes that what students understand is that things are much more complex than we think they are, without their automatically thinking that all opinions are valid. I don't think that. And I hope to stress that in my classes. It's not easy to do. It's really hard to do. I try.
Aquí llegó,
this is Bomba.
Aquí
Kill Bomba.
Llegó.
This is Puerto Rico. This is my class.